Good morning, everybody. Thanks for tuning in for another dose for virtual vitamin Z. My name is Danae. I'm an education specialist here at the Detroit Zoological Society, where we are celebrating and saving wildlife every day. So today we are at the Spoonbill Habitat. It's actually right next to the anteater's habitat here. And I have special guest, bird animal care staff, Matt. How's it going?
How you doing today? Hey, everybody.
So Matt, you mind telling us a little bit about what you do here at the zoo?
Sure. I'm a zookeeper here at the Detroit Zoo. I've been working with all the birds we have here, from penguins to the birds in the aviary to flamingos to these cool spoonbills. I've been working with the birds for about 12 years now, involved on ground and with different projects in conservation throughout.
That sounds really cool. You got a lot on your hands, so we're gonna spoon in over to our spoonbills to see if you can see them standing here in the shade. All right, so before we get started, of course, for our viewers, just remember, if you have any questions while we're here, go ahead and post them in our comment section. Somebody will keep an eye watch out for those. And if we can't get to them, we'll try to answer them as soon as we can. All right, so we do have a lot of them here. About how many does the zoo care for? And then, like, did they all come here at once, or?
So, yeah, our current flock is 19 spoonbills. There are 10 males and 9 females. We've always had a pretty healthy size flock. Sometimes we've had as many as, maybe up to a couple dozen, but usually somewhere around 20. A lot of the birds have been raised here and born here. Some of the birds have come from other zoos. Sometimes we will switch birds with other zoos to try and keep the genetics fresh.
Okay, all right, sounds really cool. Are they all about the same age, or?
Yeah, so we have a variety of ages here. Some of these guys are only a couple years old, birds that were raised by our birds. And we have birds as old as 34 years old. And our one bird named Dot, it's a female, and she's 34 years old. And that is the oldest spoonbill ever recorded anywhere, ever.
Oh, wow. So, I mean, well, how long do you think they will live in the wild in general?
So in the wild, they could probably live a couple decades. They're not going to live as long in the wild, because here at the Detroit Zoo, we're going to give them the best health care they can have. Whereas in the wild, if you get older and you get sick and you get injured, unfortunately, a predator is going to pick you off or you're going to starve. But right, they're fortunate enough to be here, so if they get sick, we figure out what the problem is and get them back in good health. And that's how we can have birds as old as Dot, 34 years old, and she's still doing very well.
All right. Well, that's awesome. Okay, let's see. Where in the wild will we find spoonbills?
Yep. So as their name dictates, the African spoonbill has a pretty good size range, not so much in the northern part of Africa, but throughout central and southern Africa. And kind of to touch on the habitats they would be in there, you can see they have that unique spoon type bill, which is where they get their name from. And they would be located in different marshy areas or areas where you're going to have some shallow water or some seasonal flooding.
Okay, so do they lay their nests on the ground, or do they lay nests in the trees?
Yeah, so they'll build their nests in a colony, just like we have a nice group here, and they're going to build it up in trees. Probably not super high up in trees, but up a bit into the tree, and they're going to use some sticks and build a nice platform type nest, and they might line it with leaves or use whatever they can to make a nice little area for the eggs and eventually the chicks.
Okay, so you said that they build their nests in colonies, so I'm assuming that they're pretty social birds, or?
Yeah, they are social birds, and kind of as you see right now, you know, there's a little spacing between them, but as a whole, they're really hanging out as a flock. They'll be foraging together. We have a nice wallow in their habitat here, and they will... they'll forage together in there, or they'll hang out as they're kind of, you can see they're working and preening their feathers, taking good care of them. But yeah, they like to hang out together.
All right. Okay. So you mentioned that their bills are kind of different. Everybody can kind of see that. They have kind of a spoon-shaped bill towards the end. of their beak. Are they born that way, or do they...
Very, very little spoon at first, but, okay. but right when they're born, you can already see that shape starting to form.
Okay.
And as they grow rapidly, they just continue to elongate that out. But yep, they're born with that spoon, and it's a really cool adapted beak. There's a few different species of spoonbills throughout the world. What we might know in the U.S. better would be roseate spoonbills, which you'll see in the southern U.S., but it's the same exact design where you have that cool spoon, which is built to ideally be working in the muck or in a shallow pond, and they can just be filtering back and forth and finding little organisms, fish, different invertebrates, maybe I'm sure they'd get a frog with it, all kinds of different things, and that's what they'd be eating.
Okay, so they obviously don't eat seeds like other birds, so I guess we can call them carnivores?
Yeah, I definitely would, yep, and what we touched on, yeah, they're going to eat lots of fish, and we provide them plenty of fish in their diet here. We'll also provide them krill, little shrimp-like creatures, plenty of invertebrates. We like to give them crickets and different insects here, and other meat items. They would eat frogs in the wild.
Okay, so they look pretty small. If you had to guess how much they weighed,
yeah,
how big would they be?
So, a little bit of variability. Spoonbills have a little bit of sexual dimorphism. Their plumage looks the same, but between males and females, females generally weigh less than the males.
Mm-hmm.
And I would say a smaller female is just going to be 2 to 3 pounds maybe, and the males might get up in the 4 to 5 pound range.
Okay, so they're actually pretty small. Do they tend to migrate like other birds?
Yeah, so they will migrate, but generally their migration patterns are more need-based. So within their habitat and range, they may be migrating based on some annual flooding, or whereas their food source kind of dries up and the ponds and marshes they're enjoying dry up, they're going to have a movement within their habitat to find a new thriving area that's full of water.
Okay, so you said that their habitat can kind of dry up, so they do kind of migrate just based on needs. Have they ever had to move around because of any threats that they might face in the wild? So are they considered endangered at all?
So yeah, spoonbills are interesting. They are a species of least concern, which is excellent. But we currently believe they have a stable population. But just as so many other species are struggling with, they definitely struggle with habitat loss as we continue to work into different wild and remote areas. Their population is rather hard to estimate based on them being in some very remote areas. But they're certainly an important species to talk about, because as we see them as least concern, it still can be hard to know really how many are out there, and we don't want it to be a thing where we would forget about them because it's hard to track them.
True. So is Detroit Zoo doing anything as far as like conservation when it comes to the spoonbills? I mean, I know they're least concern, but...
Oh, no, definitely. But yeah, we're trying to teach everybody about the different habitats they are in and about what a unique species this is. And we do plenty of conservation all over. We also do some conservation in Africa with helping out with vultures. So we do a lot of help in Africa.
Okay, that's awesome. So I don't know if you guys have noticed that they have been moving a lot. I guess they're kind of shy when it comes to people, but are there any other behaviors that the guests might see while they're here?
Yeah, while they're here, sometimes you might see them. They certainly seem to enjoy the sun, just like we might like to get in it. So that might be part of the reason they're moving, is as the sun's coming through the different trees and spots in the canopy here they're working. So you'll definitely see them moving around the habitat looking for the sun. A lot of times you see some of them doing right now, where it looks like maybe they're itching their back or poking around, and they're just working on their feathers, preening their feathers. Birds spend a lot of time doing that. Their feathers are such an important part of their survival. What allows them to fly, it's what keeps them warm, it's what protects them. So they're constantly taking good care of them. And you'll see them working by their pool, or even on the back side of the pool, we have a nice wallow area simulating exactly what they'd have in the wild. And you'll see them working their spoons in there looking for anything to eat.
All right. So let's see, do you have any cool stories about these specific spoonbills that we have here?
Yeah, one off the top of my head is, so we talked about it earlier, a lot of these spoonbills have been raised here.
Right.
And the parents do a pretty good job of it, but sometimes they need a little help from us. So in one instance, we had a bird named Elmer. And Elmer wouldn't have made it without us because his egg had a nice crack-like hole in it that, you know, it probably just got damaged,
right,
maybe on the nest, or, you know, maybe birds were fighting too close. So we took the egg, we repaired it with Elmer's glue, we finished the incubation of it, got it to hatch out, and raised it up. And now we have a great spoonbill named Elmer, so that's how he got his name.
All right. Well, I will hope I get to see Elmer up close, aside from them moving around. They're sunbathing spoonbills right now. Well, thanks again, Matt, for joining me today and giving us some insight on these really cool birds out here. I have to say they're probably one of my favorites because of the way they look, really. But again, I hope you guys enjoyed our video. Tune in again for more live videos. Make sure you hit like on that Detroit Zoo page, and remember to stay safe and have a great day.